Hey, I'm Mike. I like music, and I have probably the most important question for you so far out of all the videos I've done. What is the correct way to order an iced coffee with light ice? Because it doesn't matter where I go, whether it's a big chain or a local place, far and wide, it doesn't matter how I order it. Doesn't matter what I say. Little bit of ice, light ice, less ice, a specific quantity of ice, only a bit of ice, some ice, a small amount of ice, half the normal amount of ice you would put in, or any other wording that I can think of. I've tried it all, and the result is always one of two things. I get an iced coffee that has no change in the quantity of ice, and therefore my coffee is watered down, or I get a coffee that's room temperature, not sure what that's all about, and it has like four or five already melted ice cubes in it, and it... Huh? Rage. All that I want is a coffee that's cold and it's not watered down. That's all that I want, and that's all that I want. Please give me any ideas as to what to do better, because I just want that. In this video, I'm listening to Would've, Could've, Should've, which is, you all think that I'm gonna love this song, so I'm really nervous going into this, because there's an expectation now. Because of all the comments, there's an expectation, and I'm worried that I'm kind of being set up to love this song, and it might not live up to my expectations, so I'm nervous, guys. I'm nervous. Watch me just absolutely hate it. If you would have blinked, then I would have looked away at the first glance. If you tasted poison, you could have spit me out at the first chance. If I wasn't painted, it's splatter on a promising grown man. And if I was a child, it didn't matter if you got to wash your hands. Taylor's just flexing with her vocals on this one. Gone along with the righteous. If I never blushed, then they could have never whispered about this. And if you never saved me from boredom, I could have gone on as I was. But Lord, you made me feel important, and then you tried to erase us. Oh, you're a crisis of my faith. Would have, could have, should've. If I'd only played it safe, I would've stayed on my knees. And I damn sure never would've danced with the devil at 19. And the God's honest truth is that the pain was heaven. And now that I'm grown, I'm scared of ghosts. Memories feel like weapons. And now that I know, I wish you left me wandering. God bless my soul. I miss who I used to be. The tomb won't close. Stained glass windows in my mind. I regret you all the time. I can't let this go. I fight with you in my sleep. The wound won't close. I keep on waiting for a sign. I regret you all the time.
Yeah, she's like, this is a diss track. Night.
So I don't know if I was supposed to get emotional during that, but I definitely did. So thanks again, Taylor. So I did like it. I would definitely add that to my playlist and listen to it on the radio. I wouldn't rank that anywhere higher than the songs I've liked so far. That's what kind of what, like, when I was coming into the song, that's where the bar was for me. Like, this is the best song on the album. I don't know if anyone actually said that, but I don't know, from all the comments I was like, oh, this is really setting the bar high. It's still a good song, and I don't think my expectations going in diminished my liking of the song, but just in terms of the context there, yeah, I wouldn't rank this above any of the others. One thing that was a little bit funny to me while I was listening to this was that I felt like Taylor was just talking so fast. Like, there's so much going on in terms of like the delivery of her vocals, and it was funny because like I listen to metal and I can understand that pretty clearly, but this I was having a hard time following, like, what is going on? But I think this was really a perfect combination of a backtrack that I enjoyed and I felt really suited the song, and Taylor just killed it on the vocals there with the lyrics too. Specifically, this was, I don't know, it came across as a diss track, and I kind of more so towards the middle than the second half of the songs when I really started paying attention to the songs. And that's when I started getting emotional, because it was like, one of the things I've really been trying to stay conscious of is my impact on other people's life, because I just want to reduce the amount of times that I'm a ghost to someone in a bad way, like a memory that just, that it scars them in a way. And there are people that, unfortunately, I probably am not a good memory to them. And it hurts me to know that that's like, at whatever point in my life that was like that, that is the effect I had on someone, is that whether it's just whenever, maybe it's like they pass by a restaurant or something, like, oh yeah, that reminds me of Mike, and God, I hate that guy. Or maybe it's just something I did, and it's like I created a permanent scar that, or an insecurity, or just a self-doubt or something like that. Just whatever it was, like, it sucks knowing that I have had that effect, I'm sure, on people, but like that I can still have that effect. So this song is like a reminder, I guess, for me in a way to stay diligent on the way that I treat people and the way that I interact with people, because it's important too to recognize that, like, sometimes you don't even know what you're doing is going to have a big impact. Because one of the things I was watching recently was a clip from Jon Bernthal's, I forget his name, his podcast, the guy from Walking Dead and Punisher. He had a podcast with Laurie from The Walking Dead, and this specific clip was about, I think it was about being a woman in Hollywood, and I forget the actress's name, but I'll just refer to her as her character's name of Laurie. So she was talking about how on a different film set, she was the center of attention when it came to, there was this video going around online, and it was a pornographic video, and the guys on the set were like, oh, you look like this girl. And she didn't take kindly to that. And that was something that she didn't feel comfortable with, and she didn't like at all. It was something that stuck with her, and it was something that just really bothered her. And I don't remember the timeline, but eventually, it might have been like years later, she brought this up to one of the people that had made that joke. She's like, yeah, that really messed me up. And the guy had replied, I what are you talking about? Because for him, that wasn't even worth remembering. That was just a thing he did. Like, what did you have for breakfast 16 months ago to the day? Like, do you remember that? You probably don't. And that was kind of his perspective when it came to this big event in this actress Lori's life. And obviously that's like a bigger thing, but it could even be something like not saying hello or not being polite to someone. Like, that could have an impact on them, because maybe this specific day they're just not feeling it, and maybe lately they just haven't been feeling respected, and suddenly like you're the straw that breaks that camel's back, and suddenly you get that ball rolling into this pit of some sort. And kind of taking it back to the song, because I know I've been a little bit long-winded here, but I really appreciate that this song did that for me. In essence, I mean, it reads as another relationship song, but there's a deeper meaning behind that. And through reading your comments, I've learned that not every song that I've interpreted as a relationship song is one, but also there's ones that sound like they are, but they're about like not just a romantic relationship. There's like relationships with the fans and other relationships as well. Like, not everything has to be romantic. And it's I'm trying to kind of keep that in mind whenever I see or hear a song that's Taylor's, and it's like, oh, this sounds like a romantic relationship. It doesn't have to be. And if you're watching this far, I appreciate it. I do have a little bit more I wanted to say to the thing I was talking about before. So one of the things from that line of thought that really fascinates me is everyone's fork in the road. For me to get to today, to be the person that I am, to have the securities and the insecurities that I have as a person, there were multiple forks in the road where I deviated from the first path that I was ever on, and it led me here. And one thing I find myself getting more and more fascinated with is thinking of not only my own forks in the road, but other people's, like trying to just be considerate of what it took to get them to this point. Because I don't think that people are just the way that they are without pretense. I feel like there's always an explanation, even if the explanation would end up sucking and it's like, oh, that's lame, or not lame, but like, you know what I mean? It's like, it's like, okay, like, it doesn't mean that you should act like that, or I don't think you should maybe act like that. It's still a reason that got them there. And then kind of circling back around to myself, I just love thinking back and like taking something about myself and trying to trace back the steps. Like, what was the very first decision that made me be this way? And it doesn't have to be like an emotional thing. It could be just a decision, like my decision to make this channel, for example. Like, where did that start? Like, what was the very first time that I had that idea? What was the first thing that I saw or was inspired by that eventually led to me having that idea? Like, that kind of backtracing stuff is so fascinating to me. And that was a lot of words to say for this song to have reminded me of. But that was what it coulda, shoulda. That's not technically the song, but I guess I'll keep it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow.